Hey guys, it's the Hope Coach, Lori LeBlanc, coming to you from beautiful Texas. It's a little overcast today, so no sunglasses. I wanted to do a quick follow-up on the video I recorded last week on Friday about congruency. And I've been thinking a lot about that this weekend, and I know one of the things I said on the video was I was going to make a list of my top five goals that I had in my life and keep it with me so that I could focus my daily activities on things that were going to help me get to those goals. And so I just, as a little bit of accountability, here's my list. I did write it out last night, so going into the week, I have my top five things that I want to create in my life. And I also listed a couple of, well, quite a few actually, action steps that I can take that are going to help me in those five areas. And so I wanted to kind of talk today a little bit about the trap of busyness. And I know this is something that I have found myself in pretty much my entire life. We get very busy and we think that that's a productive life. And what I wanted to talk about is kind of what I've realized is that busyness does not get you the results that you want unless you're focused on what those results are. Unless you're focused on what you want to accomplish, the busyness that you encounter on your day-to-day, in your day-to-day life, just gets you tired at the end of the day. But does it really propel you towards what it is that you want, the kind of life that you actually want to lead? And so I started thinking about this trap of business. I'm a mom. I work. I'm doing a lot of personal growth right now, taking several classes that are helping me in these areas. I'm putting together a business plan for something that is on my, the number one item on my list that I want to accomplish. And so I'm very busy, and it's very easy to let the trap of busyness keep us from the things that are important to us. And so when I think about the day, you know, I know for me personally, there's probably 10 things I can be doing in any given moment of the day. I mean, when you have kids, you know what it is. There's always dishes. There's always laundry. There's always picking up or taking someone somewhere, buying groceries, cooking food for them. I mean, that list just goes on and on and on. And you can get very caught up in just treading water, trying to stay afloat with all of these things that you need to do on a day-to-day basis. But at the end of the day, all you were was busy, you know, but does it really equate to the results that you want to see in your life? And the problem with that is that a busy day repeated the next day, and the next day turns into a busy week. And then those busy weeks turn into busy months and busy years. And before long, you know, years have gone by when you still have that dream in your heart and you've really not done anything to get you closer to that dream. And every year we start over on January 1st, and you know, everybody has the resolutions, and this year I'm going to do it. This year, this thing that's been burning a hole in my soul is going to happen. I'm going to do it this year. And year after year, we let the trap of busyness keep us from actually accomplishing those things that mean the most to us. Now, I'm not discounting taking care of your family, and those things are important, obviously. There's still something that's burning inside of you that you want to accomplish. And year after year, that gets put on the back burner because of busyness, because of all the things you feel like you have to do on a day-to-day basis. Well, I'm here to tell you, at some point, you won't have another January 1st. At some point, you won't have any more time to do that thing that is burning a hole in your soul. So when are you going to stop the busyness and start taking actions that actually get you closer to those goals and to that thing that just makes you come alive? You know, we only have a certain amount of time in this lifetime. the top five things that you want to see in your life. And it can be anything. Everybody has their own. Some of mine are working on this business plan that I, creating this business that I want to create in my life that I think will be a tremendous benefit to a lot of people. It can be very transformative for a lot of people. Finding myself getting involved in a conscious relationship, financial freedom, having a healthy presence in this world, and self-care. Those are my top five items. So my action items for the day are all going to be centered around this. I'm going to hold this paper with me all day, and I'm going to read it. I'm going to think about the things that I'm doing on a hourly basis, minute by minute basis, and ask myself that question. Is what I'm doing right now going to get me closer to these goals in any one of these categories? Is what I'm doing, when you have some downtime and you're scrolling through Facebook, ask yourself, is this going to get me closer to these goals? And if you can keep your focus on these five things that you've created your list around, I think that will really help keep you focused on the type of activities that you can do on a daily basis that'll get you closer to those goals. So anyway, that's my spiel on the trap of busyness. And I get it. I've been there. And this is my solution for utilizing my time better and actually getting closer to these things that are important to me, instead of just by default staying busy all day long doing things that are really not contributing to the results that I want to see.